glad that you're here. How many are glad to be at our third service today? Say amen. Amen. If you're joining us online, we are glad that you are with us. Today is a little bit unique and different. You are free to sit where you are, relax, enjoy the presence of the Lord and the ensemble and choir and all that is December at North Place Church. Say amen if you're glad you're here.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
Oh, come, O come, O come.
worship. I'm glad that you're with us. How many are glad you're here? You're just glad to be here. If you're joining us online, we're glad that you're joining us online for our third service. We've sat back, we've relaxed, we've enjoyed it, but here's what I want you to do now. I want you to reach down in front of you. There should be either a shaker or a tambourine, possibly a bell, maybe a pair of sticks. There's something there. That's it. And don't sit down on me. I've got emails all year long about people wanting to be involved in the worship team. This is your chance to be involved in the worship team. This is it. If you have a shaker, hold that shaker. Let me hear it. That's it. The whole balcony. This is what we call anointed shaking. Anointed shaking. There's a bell.
Here we go. All right, awesome.
All right, if you have rhythm sticks, hold them up. You see them.
Over here.
All right.
And worship leader's worst nightmare, tambourine. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to do an interactive game with this. On each side of me, there are screens, and we have instruments. We are your leader. If you have a shaker, I'm your leader. If you have a tambourine, Gabe is your leader. If you have a bell, then John is your leader. And if you have rhythm sticks over in this whole section, let me see them real quick. If you have rhythm sticks, this whole section. All right, Brittany, your response to represent rhythm sticks. That's right. And so here's what we're going to do. We're going to play a game, and we're going to sing some Christmas songs. We want you to use your instrument with us. We only have one rule only. When we get done, put your instrument back where you got it. There are 10 commandments. Number 8 says, thou shalt not steal. We make a lot of memories here at North Place Church, and that's what we do. You are home. Home does not mean take the things with you when you leave. Home means leave them in the seat pocket ahead of you. All right, so are you ready? Say yes. All right, if you will, turn your attention to the screen. If you will. Just that easy. All you have to do is follow your instrument. Be ready. Shakers. All right, some of you are having trouble already. I just follow the shaking. That's all you need to do. If you can't see that far, just listen. Listen for it. That's all you need to do. That's it. You're with me now. Nice job, shakers. Nice job.
All right, bells. Let me hear the bells. Come on. Ready? There you go. There we go. Good job. Awesome.
All right, let's get ready. Here we go, sticks. Here we go.
Wow. That's impressive.
Oh, you got it. There we go. Good job.
All right, tambourines, let's show them how it's done. Come on. First of all, us. Not too soon. Stay with me. Not too fast. Alright, just make some noise. Alright, pay attention, man.
That's it. Come on.
Thank you.
Week. We've had a lot of creative elements. You saw the ice sculpture as you came in, the flutes as you came in, the gift bags. We've had a lot of creative elements, and next week you're not going to want to miss our grand finale on the 22nd of December. Pastor.
And if you have an issue downloading that app, find the nearest nine-year-old and out. It'll get it for you. Amen. I found a new idea today watching all of us try to hit on beat. We need a small group for rhythmically impaired folks. I would need to be the first one to sign up. I look like Frankenstein trying to hit on beat. I enjoyed it once we got going. I enjoy watching you do it. I enjoy having a good time. And I'm so grateful to all of the people from the flautists to the I have been cultured too. They're not flute players, they're flautists. I'm learning. And the ice sculptor, all of the things that are going on today, choir, the people that have put into that this entire month. And we're just glad you chose to be a part of this third Sunday of Advent with North Place Church. So let me invite you, if you're guests today, to join us. Haley and I will be joining up with some of our team in the back after the service. It's kind of down towards the kids area, my right area in the west end of the building, the connection place. We'd love to greet you today if you're a guest, or if you brought family or friends with you today, bring them by. We have some refreshments, homemade cupcakes, things like that. We'd love to just get a moment, just say hi and get to know you. I'm going to ask our service hosts, if they will, to help me. They're going to come down the aisle with our bulletin, and inserted inside that is a communication card. We don't want to single you out, but if you're a guest, when they walk by, or maybe you brought a guest, just kind of raise your hand so they can hand you one of these, because inserted inside it is a communication card. We would love for you to fill that card out, place it in the offering that we will receive just a moment, and it will help us in a more personal way say thanks for being in service with us today. When you came in, you received a token of appreciation, a small gift of hot chocolate wrapped up a little nostalgically, so you can go home and have a little bit of home, a little bit of family time. But also inserted inside there were two cards. You'll find Merry Christmas from North Place Church, and on the back is the website. Our goal is that you will use these two cards. There's more where that came from between now and Christmas Eve, and you will invite people to be back with you next Sunday for Christmas Sunday. People are waiting, their families right now today that aren't in church, that are discussing, hey honey, what are we gonna do for Christmas this year? Where are we gonna go to church? They don't have a church home. All they're doing is waiting for somebody to invite them. And so we want you to utilize these and tell somebody Merry Christmas, and then invite them. They can go to the website, or you can give them information. Christmas services will run normally scheduled next Sunday, but then we'll have a special service on Christmas Eve, two of them actually. One of those services will be at 4:30 here in the sanctuary. One of them will be at 4. Thank you for the pause there. It was a dramatic pause. And then one of them will be at 5:30. It's in your bulletin correctly. And those will shoot for about 60 minute or less services there. It'll be stripped down, bare bones, sacred worship, communion, a little bit of the word, and just celebrating the eve of Christ's birth with our faith family. And we want you to be here to be a part of that. Also, most of you know that we have a camp every summer for orphans and foster kids. It's a big part of our year. We raise money for it and give to it and serve. But we want to extend that reach to that part of our world beyond one week out of the year. And there's some people in our church that have this heart, that have lived this, walked this. And they've invited some representatives from our state government in Austin, along with some faith-based folks who are well-versed in the area of orphan care and fostering. And so on the 18th of January, we're going to have a little seminar conference type for those that are interested. It'll happen at 9 a.m. here on the campus on the 18th of January for anybody that is burdened with orphan and foster care issues. Now for those of you that say, I might want to adopt, it's a good place to come. For those of you that say, I could never adopt, but somebody tell me a creative way to get involved, that's what this is about. Whether it's you open your home once a quarter to a foster family who needs a break for one night, or you babysit a kid while they go out on a date because they're fostering all the time, or whether it's other ways to mentor and interact with these students, these foster kids, then, or ways to get involved with kids that are about to age out of the system. It is a way for us to mobilize our church and put skin on. And from government agencies to faith-based leaders, they're going to meet with us on Saturday, the 18th of January, and give us some directions as a church on how we can be mobilized to help. And I would love for you to be a part of that. Amen. And they'll be serving with Pastor John Gregg at Calvary Church, phenomenal church, phenomenal man. Just to give you a little background information, the reason I say it's bittersweet is because, it seems like Lindsay was a young girl, but it's only been 8.5 years ago, but you're still a young girl, because you were a young, young girl. And to be interacting with her as a pastor, Lindsay and her family have been a part of this church since before I got here 8.5 years ago, before Gabe arrived. But I met Gabe when he was a Bible college student. I came through to preach chapel, and he just said, my heart connects with your vision. I want to go wherever you go. Well, I was pastoring in Arkansas at the time, and I moved to Texas, and he got to the end of his time at Bible college, and I just thought I would never see Gabe again, and he called and said, I'm coming. I said, what do you mean you're coming? He said, I told you I was going to go wherever you go. I said, well, I don't have a job. He said, I don't need a job. I'm just going to come land down there. And he did, and made himself so valuable we couldn't let him leave. And he's been here 8 years doing everything you could imagine, from building sheetrock walls to building walls. Yes, I had to mention that, building walls. He built a wall. I didn't have permission to build one. He built it while John and I were on a missions trip out the country, because he believed it was easier to get forgiveness than it was permission. You understand? So being here 8 years has matured him to the place to be a blessing to Calvary Church. He's like a son to me. He's kind of like my kid's older brother. Lindsay's kind of like their older sister. So it's a bittersweet moment. But it's the same thing of kind of like Caden's a couple years from graduating high school. When I take him to college, whichever one he chooses, it's going to be a bittersweet deal. I'm going to be sad that the season of life is over, and I'll be excited about the potential and destiny in his future. I haven't said this to you guys, but I've said it in an email, but I haven't said it publicly. I didn't say it today. I really believe with all my heart, you know, God, why can't they stay here? And I really believe God spoke to my heart about it, that there is something that he wants to do in their life and in their ministries, that if they stayed here and weren't obedient to the nudge of God in this moment, they would miss out on. Something in their development, something in their future is connected to this act of obedience. And there's something about that place and those people God is sending them to in San Francisco that is going to shape them in a way that if they stayed here, they wouldn't be shaped. And so we release them today in a bittersweetness. And their last Sunday will be next Sunday. They will be Thursday night here. We'll have a special kind of get-together. It's normally worship and tech and media practice. But for those of you that are not a part of that, we're inviting you to join with us on Thursday night, just to stop by, to come and go things, starting at 7 o'clock in the sanctuary, for you just to kind of hug and say goodbye and bless them and just love on them. And so we'd love for you to be a part of that. Today, I want you to join me in praying with them. And I just want to bless them and send them out. I want to ask God's favor and blessing over their life today as a church. And I'm going to pray kind of some way as a spiritual parent. And Lindsay's family's right up here. The Shotwells have been a blessing to this church. And they're going to continue to be. And we just... The good news is, we told Addie was like all sad, like, Lindsay's got to come back and see her family. You know, she's got to come back home, so you'll get to see her. You'll get to see them. But I want us as family, pastor, some way as spiritual parent, I want you to join me in sending them out today, if you will. Would you stand with me? And I want you to stretch your hand this way, and I want us to speak a blessing over them. Father, I represent, as an elder of this body, the hands of this congregation extended. And Lord, I want you to bless them. I want you to bless them monetarily. I want you to bless them with promotion and favor. I want you to prepare the hearts of those people at Calvary Church in the Bay Area of San Francisco to be ready for these people who are family to us. We're sending our own seed to San Francisco, and we want them to be taken care of. And we pray that you bless them, that your favor follows them, that this thing that you want to do in their life, Lord, this future thing that is bigger than any of our minds will ever be able to imagine, that because they said yes in this moment of obedience, that you will unlock that potential. And I believe their yes and our willingness to send sets this church up in the pathway of a blessing as well. We pray for your favor in every way, your blessing in every way. We pray fruit from the seed of their life and the seeds that we are going to sow in them. And I pray that you will bless that church, their lives. And Lord, may we always feel bonded, that this will always be home to them. And I pray your favor and blessing in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen.